Now, barely a week goes by this year that we don't lead the late news with a story about scandal and sport, whether it is swimming, rugby league, AFL or global cycling. The Grand Prix obviously is on this weekend. Thankfully, those involved in that sport haven't had too much scandal to worry about. But two cyclists are here and are part of the Celebrity Grand Prix. They are Sir Chris Hoy, the British Olympic champion, and also Anna Mears, who took out gold for Australia in the cycling in London. I sat down and spoke to them today about their expectations ahead of this weekend, but also the impact that the huge scandals involving cycling have had on them and their careers. Chris Hoy, Anna Mears, first of all, Chris, how are you coping with four wheels as opposed to two?
Well, it's very exciting. It's great fun. A little bit different. You know, you want to do more when you're on the straight. You want to do something to make the car go faster, but you can't. You just got to sit there and let the engine do the work for a change.
Anna, I think you guys have got an advantage. You just know how to handle corners.
Well, that's all we do. We turn left. Turning right may have been a challenge this week, but no, it's not too much trouble.
Do you enjoy the feeling of an engine as opposed to, you know, pushing with your own steam?
Yeah, no, it's not too bad actually. I'm glad I've got some decent sized legs because I can really jam it on the brakes quite well. But yeah, it's nice to hear that the engine revving as opposed to the lungs and the heart. So even though that's actually still going a million miles an hour, we were just talking about it earlier. It's the same feeling lining up on a race and the velodrome.
I know you've been out for a couple of rides in the morning. Glasgow, is it on?
At the moment it is, yeah. That's the aim, that's the dream. Whether I can do it or not, that's another matter.
Anna, you had 5 months off. How is that? And I know when I spoke to you last, you were contemplating whether or not you would give it another crack.
Yes, I was contemplating. And I wanted to be able to walk away from it for a little while and enjoy life without the bike in the picture.
So what's the ambition then?
For me, ultimately, Rio. I would love to be able to get to the Glasgow Games as well and ride on the Sir Chris Hoy velodrome.
We'll make you very welcome. Don't worry.
Yeah,
we will.
Appreciate
as long as you don't beat the Scots, then.
I'm not going to promise that.
He'll be there to greet you personally. Since the London Olympics, it's actually been a pretty tumultuous time for cycling. All the Lance Armstrong stuff obviously has dominated. Has that had any impact on you? I mean, what's the implication for sponsorship, for your career, or be it a different part of cycling?
I think it's just something people talk to you about everywhere you go, whether you're, you know, out and about in town with you know, in the public, whether it's cycling or media, whatever. People want to know what your opinion is and what you think about your sport. And it's, you know,
did you feel the sport as a whole has been tainted, that everybody involved in it somehow has to justify themselves, answer questions?
Well, I think it's our responsibility as athletes to say, well, you know, not everybody is a cheat. Not everybody takes drugs. You know, you can still win gold medals, you can still be a champion without resorting to that. And I think that maybe gets missed sometimes in the media because it seems like it's everyone's at it, you know, in the tour, and there's been so many people that have either tested positive or been implicated in retrospect. But as athletes, all we can do is go out there, compete clean, try to win gold medals and show the public and the, sort of, the next generation of cyclists, you don't have to do this. You don't, it's not a, you, if you want to win, you have to, you don't. And it's frustrating, it hurts me as a fan of the sport when you see your sport being brought into disrepute. It's, you know, it is tough, but yeah, there's not much we can do about it. All we can do is just try and set a positive example.
Anna, how about you? Any impact on things like sponsorship, the level of interest in you and your career?
Me personally, I have suffered as a result of it. Unfortunately, I've had three sponsorship contracts pulled, new potential sponsorships pulled. But very happily, I've kept my four current sponsors, and I have got one new one in CQ Properties from up where I grew up in Queensland. So whilst it's been challenging, it's still, you know, been rewarding, and I'll still always reiterate to people that it's not everyone. You know, just like there are bloody idiots on the road drink driving, not every car driver, you know, is a drunk idiot. So same with cyclists. And it's not just in cycling, it's sport in general that has an issue with drugs. And it's always going to be there because there are going to be people who want to take shortcuts.
Both of you, thank you very much. Good luck on the weekend. I'll see you on the track.
Good luck to
thanks,
me.
Yeah, good luck to you too, mate.
Yeah.
Not too much luck. I don't think you need it.
I hope you get second and third. Good luck there.
He's not half competitive, is he?